Okay, guys, so this is a bit of an odd one, and think of it as a collaborative effort of leaks containing information from our own sources as well as information that have appeared on the internet before. In which case, the credit has been given to the respective sources, which is Tom's Hardware Germany and Video Cards. There are also some new details in the mix that we will be throwing in, such as clock speeds, memory specifications, and PCB details. So we kind of split this up into two parts, confirmed and educated speculation. So let's begin with the facts. The GeForce GTX 1660 will have 6 GB of GDDR5 memory with a 192-bit bus. The memory will be clocked at 4000 MHz, while the clock speed will be 1530 MHz base with a 1785 MHz boost. The card will feature the TU116-300 die, and the board number is PG165. That's the 1660. Now on to the 1660 Ti. That, on the other hand, will have a 6 GB GDDR6 memory and 192-bit bus. This memory will be clocked at 6000 MHz, which is considerably faster than the 1660 counterpart. The base clock will be 1500 MHz, while the boost, 1770 MHz. The card is based on the TU116-400 die, and the part number is PG161 for the board, which is the same board number as the RTX 2060. This also means the die will be pin compatible with the 2060. And both cards will presumably be launching sometime around Valentine's Day this year. So you get a box of candy or a video card. Not a bad trade. So if you were here for verified and confirmed information on the 1660 series, well, this is where you want to go ahead and just skip over to the AMD Navi rumor or just turn it off in general. See, the fact that the 1660 Ti is the same board number as the RTX 2060 means that we're probably looking at the Tensor and RTX core disabled via hardware straps. It is also worth noting that a 3 GB version of the GTX 1660 is also being planned with 3 GB of GDDR5 at 4000 MHz clock. The core clocks leaked by Video Cards put the NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1660 Ti and the GTX 1660 at 5.44 teraflops and 4.57 teraflops respectively. In comparison, the RTX 2060 is going to be a 6.45 teraflops card, so the ROP counts can also be inferred by using these core counts and specifications. The GTX 1660 Ti should be priced somewhere around the $280 mark, and making it a good enough price point could make this new entry-level champion. It'll definitely be competing with the RX 590 at that level. With these specifications, you're looking at somewhere around 1070 or more level performance, so that's not going to be a really hard battle to win for them on this card. Now I'm going to add a bit to this one because I've not made a video up until now because of the idea of the 1660 and the naming scheme really hurt my head, but I do propose this question. Do you think that maybe this could be the resulting use case for the rumored mining-focused cards that were earlier discussed? I mean, it's about all that really makes sense to me at this point with the card, to be honest. Either way, on to Navi news. AMD is getting ready to launch their Radeon Navi 7 nanometer GPUs later this year. Don't think I was about to say like in the next week or so. And we know this thanks to the macOS Mojave update, which includes specific references to 4 distinct Navi GPU variants in its code base. This simply means that this leak is about as legitimate as it gets. And with that out of the way, let's jump on into the juicy bits. The code for the update in question was spotted by Gigamax on the Tony Mac x86 forum, which Video Cards picked up on. The source code includes 4 Navi graphics processors, the Navi 16, Navi 12, Navi 10, and Navi 9. Now, it's not entirely clear if each of these is a distinct GPU die, or rather a variant of the same chip. Although we already have seen references to Navi 10 and Navi 12 being 2 very distinct GPU cores on previous occasions. And this is where the company's code names can become, well, rather confusing. According to the latest chatter, AMD is still eyeing summer 2019 for a Navi launch. Specifically, sometime in July, just around where my birthday is, guys, you know, just in case you want to send something our way. This is, in fact, very much consistent with what we've been hearing over the past 4 months. It's not yet obvious how the company's upcoming Radeon 7 GPU based on 7nm Vega is going to fit into all of this, with Navi being so close, especially considering the earlier whispers have put the performance of the fastest Navi variant, the RTX 3080, at Vega 64 with about 15% uplift which is just 10% shy of AMD's $700 Radeon 7. The same rumor leaked by Adore TV also claims a $250 price tag for the same 3080 card, which, if true, would dramatically undercut AMD's on Radeon 7. Wouldn't be like they haven't done this before, but this means a combination of the three things. Either Navi isn't really as fast as it's rumored, it isn't going to be as cheap, or AMD is planning a hefty price cut for the Radeon 7 sometime in the middle of the year. Regardless, what this leak indicates is that Navi is actually quite close to the market, and Radeon 7 will not be the only new 7-nanometer GPU to release from AMD this year. So, with all of that out of the way, which one are you more excited about? The GTX 1660 and 1660 Ti, or Navi? Are you gonna wait for Navi? Or are you gonna jump on one today? If you're in that sub $300 price bracket, love to hear your comments down in the comment section below. And this has been Keith with WCCF Tech TV. Make sure that you're subscribed and hit that notification bell so that we don't miss you in the next one.